Happy Mercedesing. Hi everyone. In today's video, I'll show you exactly how to test the fuel distributor and measure fuel delivery per cylinder on both KE and KE-Jetronic system. Whether it's before or after cleaning, this is essential. What you'll need: 4, 6, or 8 identical plastic bottles, number labels to match each cylinder, a set of flexible test hoses, used once from a scrapyard, are perfect. Clean them with carb or brake cleaner. A stopwatch or your phone, a large syringe or measuring container to read the results accurately, safety gloves plus a fire extinguisher. We're dealing with fuel. How to activate the fuel pump based on model year. K and KE Jet after 1980. Pull the fuel pump relay and bridge terminals 87 and 30. Cars with mass control module, remove the mass and bridge terminals 1 and 2. K-Jet before 1979, disconnect the safety switch on the airflow sensor. The pump runs with ignition on. Some KE-Jet models, the pump may run continuously once the relay is pulled. Test and confirm. The goal is to make the pump run continuously under system pressure without the engine running. Connecting the bottles. Disconnect the hard lines going to the injectors. Attach flexible hoses and insert them into numbered bottles. Make sure the setup is secure, no leaks, no kinks. Test 1. Full throttle simulation. Fully press down the airflow sensor plate. This simulates wide open throttle. Activate the fuel pump and measure for exactly 60 seconds. Stop the pump and measure the fuel collected using a syringe or measuring cup. Record the results for each cylinder. Tolerance. Maximum deviation is plus minus 5% from the average. If one cylinder gets 50 milliliters more than other, the distributor is still dirty or the plunger is sticking. Test 2. Idle simulation. Return the fuel to the tank. Gently press the plate just enough to begin flow. This simulates idle. Run the pump again for 60 seconds. Total amount per cylinder doesn't matter. It can be 4, 6, or 10 milliliters. What matters is that differences between cylinders stay under 5%. In my video, the central plunger is stuck, so I'll only demonstrate the full throttle test. Common issues. old or deformed copper washers, leaks and inaccurate readings, low fuel pressure below 5 bar, invalid results, air in the lines, always bleed before testing. Conclusion. Anytime you clean or replace a distributor, you must run these two tests. If the values aren't balanced, the engine will idle poorly, shake, and run rough. Here, full pressure while it's shaking on idle. I don't know. Clean it again until it passes. All right, here are my results. So, are these values okay? No. Look at this. Cylinder 6 is way under, and cylinder 7 is way over. That is more than 10% deviation. This is bad. This confirms that my central plunger is either sticking or I have corrosion inside the distributor body. Time for another deep clean. One of the cylinders, cylinder 7, delivered 230 milliliters of fuel in 1 minute. That's huge. And based on that, here's my conclusion. And I really want to stress this part. 4 cylinders failed the test. I measured a 10% deviation from the average. Now remember, the upper limit for imbalance is 5%. That means, and I repeat, not a single cylinder passed the test. None. Zero. So what does this mean in real life? It means the engine would run with a very rough idle, if it idles at all. It also means that the fuel distributor is clogged, likely due to corrosion, and that the cleaning needs to be repeated. This kind of result is your warning sign. If you're still getting these differences after cleaning, the plunger is sticking or the internal slits are partially blocked. No amount of tuning can fix that. Only a proper cleaning can. Well, if your car shakes, misfires, or doesn't idle, check this before blaming your injectors or spark plugs. This test tells you the truth.